to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Crowds asked John the Baptist, "What should we do?" He said to them in reply, "Whoever has two cloaks should share with the person who has none. Whoever has food should do likewise." Even tax collectors came to be baptized, and they said to him, "Teacher, what should we do?" He answered, "Stop collecting more than what is prescribed." Soldiers also asked him, "And what is that? What is it that we should do?" He told them, "Do not practice extortion. Do not falsely accuse anyone. Be satisfied with your wages." Now the people were filled with expectation, and all were asking in their hearts whether John might be the Christ. John answered them all, saying, "I am baptizing you with water, but one mightier than I is coming. I am not worthy to loosen the thongs of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fan is in his hand to clear his threshing floor, to gather the wheat into his barn. But the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire." Exhorting them in many other ways, he preached good news to the people. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Savior is coming, who will baptize the fire of the Holy Spirit. The good news of John is that we are called to be human in his sight. God made us to be us, to be good and right and just and holy. Above all, maybe the most beautiful thing is God made us to be in relationship with him. When John says, prepare the way, sure, it has to do with these virtues he talks about. But above all, it has to do with preparing the way of the Lord. Get ready, our Savior is coming. It's he who we need to be in relationship with. It's he who we need to make a space for. It's he who we have to build up those bonds of love. Advent's a great season to do that. Take that step back, to take that deep breath in the quiet of these dark winter mornings as the world is so sleepy around us. Can we reassess? Can we reform? Can we prepare the way of the Lord?
I love you, Lord. I love you.